Good morning, students. Let's do English worksheet today. So I request all of you to remove your worksheet number 5. We will be doing with part 1 of this worksheet. Before we start solving the worksheet, I request you all to write your name, division and roll number. So here you go. You can see the worksheet displayed on your screen. So let us do with the topic, that is homograph and homophones. Question number 1. Use the following words and its homographs in 2 separate sentences. Number 1, firm. Children, before solving, let us understand what is homograph. You have already studied. Homograph means a word, or I can say a same word, a word with same spelling and same pronunciation but different meaning. So let's see. You have to use this particular given word in 2 different sentences having 2 different meanings. Let's see. Number 1. My neighbor recently joined an electronic firm as sales executive. Children, here firm plays the meaning of company. Number 2, many people feel that they must be firm with their children. And here firm means to be strict or strong. So in this way, we have completed 2 sentences with the given word having different meanings. Let's see. Number 2, lock. There was a lock of hair on the table. Here lock means it's playing a role of collective noun. You know, when there are many pieces of hair, so we call it as lock. Here lock is similar to like group, you know, or a bunch. Let's see the other meaning in sentence number 2. The lock and the key were both missing. So here the lock means the same lock which we put to lock our house, you know. So there is a difference in both the words meaning. Similarly, let's see number 3, planned. We must plant more trees to attract rain. So here plant plays the role of, you know, verb, where plant means to grow. Second sentence, the new plant for fertilizers started production last year. Here the new plant means, you know, the plant which is living thing. So in this way, again, these both sentences have different meaning with same sounding word. So I hope it's clear. Let's move to question number 2, that is name and explain figures of speech. You have been doing this since previous standards. So let's see. Dairy, desert, sand of dead habit. Children, now it's my advice to you that whenever you are doing figures of speech, you don't have to think a lot. At the first glance, whatever figure of speech comes to your mind, let's focus that. So seeing this sentence, what instantly comes to my mind is alliteration, of course. let's explain what is alliteration. So that is sound of alphabet, D is repeated. In this way, I have explained my figure of speech. Number two, where the word has not been broken up into fragments. Fragment means pieces. Again, instantly what strikes to my mind is alliteration, because the sound of alphabet, W, is repeated. Sand teeth, sand eyes, sand taste, sand everything. Here sense means without. Now this figure of speech is repetition. Why? Because here not only single alphabet, but the entire word, that is sense, is repeated for poetic effect. Fourth one, they do not sweat and whine about their condition. Children, this is tautology. What is tautology? A figure of speech with same meaning words. So what are the same meaning words here? Sweat. Here sweat means, you know, to complain, and whine means against, to cry. So, you know, animals were not complaining or crying about their condition. So that's what the explanation goes. The words sweat and whine are same in meaning. Last, bestow this jewel also on my creature. Children, this is example of metaphor figure of speech. Now you know metaphor means where one object is indirectly compared to another object. Let's see which object is getting compared to which. Of course, one is jewel. Now with whom the jewel is getting compared? Bestow, that is bestow this jewel. This jewel means here, this jewel means a jewel named rest. So the rest jewel is compared to all other jewels. So in this way it is indirectly compared. So the explanation goes, the gift of rest is indirectly compared to a jewel. Children, I hope you have followed this. So this was for the day. We'll be seeing part 2 in our next video. Till then, take care, stay safe. Thank you.